Okay, does anybody know what Tuesday is?
Tuesday.
Do we have school on Tuesday?
Yes.
No, it's on Monday.
Tuesday.
Yeah, we have
school. Tuesday's election day.
No, we don't have school.
We don't have school on Tuesday because it's election day.
Here's your phone. Where's your phone?
I already have
it
set up.
We have Tuesday off.
Yeah, we have Tuesday off because it's election day. Does anybody know what happens on election day? Angelina, what happens on election day?
People vote,
right? Does anybody know what voting is?
Oh, yeah.
How about you turn and talk with your partners and tell them what voting is? Christian, turn to Jabari. Raswell, you don't have a partner? Okay, no. Jabari, go to Raswell, okay? And you guys can talk. Okay, so I heard Soriana up front. She was telling me you can vote on what your favorite food is. What are some other ways that we can vote? Emma? For a new mayor or for a new president, so in the government we vote, right? So who we want to run things. Eli, how else can we vote?
We can vote for what we can do for life.
Okay. Go ahead, Zoriana.
You can vote for a movie.
You can vote for a movie? That's great. Because my example was when I vote, I'm old enough to vote for who I want to run for mayor or who I want to be president. But I also vote with my friends about what movie we're going to watch. How many people here vote with someone about what movie they're gonna watch? Or maybe we're outside and we're on the playground and we're gonna vote about what game we're gonna play. Who here has voted on what game we're gonna play? Right? Okay. So today, we're gonna read Duck for President. Okay, so two things we need to know. We need to know what voting means, so say vote. Vote is the process of a group choosing someone or something, okay? An election, say election,
election,
is how you vote. It's the formal process. Okay? You're not going to be here. No one's going to be here.
I am.
Let me see.
There's no school.
Yeah, because my dad sits at the table.
Oh, how cool is that? So you get to be here when no one else is, right? That's really cool. Yes,
I might be there.
I just know something. I saw the title and it says Duck for President.
Yep, so Duck for President's our title. So as good readers, we always read the title and we say Duck for President. And now I'm wondering, based on the picture on this book, do you think this is the duck that's going to run for president?
Yes.
How many people think he's going to win? Do you think he's going to become president? Give me a hands up if you think he's going to be president. But does he win? Yeah, you think he wins? How many people think he's a good president? So this is a fiction book because... Because ducks can't run for president, right? Can an animal run for president?
Maybe.
No. Maybe in our dreams, right? Nope. Okay, so we're gonna read it. Ready? Duck for President. Can anybody see what this says up here on the airplane? Heather, can you read it to everyone?
Vote.
It says vote. Running a farm is very hard work. At the end of each day, Farmer Brown is covered from head to toe in hay, horsehair, seeds, sprouts, feathers, filth, mud, muck, and coffee stains. He doesn't smell very good either. Yes, Heather?
Mm-hmm.
Look how dirty the farmer looks.
There's the pig sleeping.
The animals have chores too. Pigs clean under the beds, cows weed the garden, sheep sheep the barn, ducks take out the trash, mow the lawn, grind the coffee beans.
Natalie, I know what that is. It's common sense.
It's okay. Who has the most chores on this page? Jabari?
The duck.
The duck. He has three chores and everybody else has one. At the end of each day, the pigs are covered in lint bunnies, the cows are covered in weeds, and the sheep are covered in dust. The duck is covered in tiny bits of grass and espresso beans. Okay, now as good readers, we're constantly painting a mental picture or visualizing what's happening in the book. So can everyone close their eyes? I want you to picture how dirty the animals must be after doing their chores. Ew, right? Duck did not like to do chores. He didn't like picking tiny bits of grass and espresso beans out of his feathers. Why is Farmer Brown in charge anyway, thought the duck. We need an election. Can anyone remind me what an election is? Mark?
Voting.
He made a sign and hung it on the barn. Farmer Brown must go. Farm election tomorrow. So who is the duck running against? Emma?
Farmer Brown.
And what are they running for?
They're running for the one who's going to be like president, I think.
Who's going to be in charge of the farm?
It goes
The next morning, Farmer Brown found a poster on his front door. Vote duck for kinder, gentler farm. Farmer Brown was furious. He ran to the barn and found the animals registering to vote. Voters registration. Voters must 1. Live on the farm, 2. Show valid ID, and 3. Be at least this tall. The mice got together and protested the height requirement, so Duck crossed it off. On election day, each of the animals, I didn't show you the pictures. Look at the mice. Can anyone see the mice?
Yeah.
Would they have met the height requirement?
No.
No, right? Yep. On election day, each of the animals filled out a ballot and placed it in the box. The vote was counted. The results were posted on the barn wall. Farmer Brown 6, Duck 20. Who won the election?
Duck.
Radislaw?
Duck.
How do we know Duck won the election? Jezely? So the duck had more votes, so more votes means he won the election. Farmer Brown demanded a recount. One sticky ballot was found stuck to the bottom of a pig. The new tally was Farmer Brown 6, Duck 21. The voters had spoken. Duck was officially in charge. Turn and talk and tell your partner how you feel that the duck's in charge. So as good readers, now that we know that they didn't like chores, right? Taking everything that we know, the animals don't like doing their chores. Duck especially did not like doing their chores, and that's why he ran against the farmer. Can we understand why the animals might have voted for Duck? Why do you think the animals might have voted for Duck? What can we infer? Radislaw?
Because he does not like chores, and he's not gonna do chores.
So because he doesn't like to do chores, and the animals didn't really like to do chores, the animals voted for Duck. Yet. The duck has a long way to go. Running a farm is very hard work. At the end of each day, Duck was covered from head to toe in hay, horsehair, seeds, sprouts, feathers, filth, mud, muck, and coffee stains. Running a farm is no fun at all, thought Duck. That night, Duck and his staff started working on Duck's campaign for governor. Does anybody know what the governor runs? Does anybody have a guess of what the governor might run?
The White House.
Emma?
The White House?
The president runs the White House. The governor runs the state.
I was about to say state.
So you're going to say state?
Yeah.
So like Pennsylvania. If Duck was on a farm in Pennsylvania, you would be running for governor for Pennsylvania. Could you imagine Duck being your governor, running your state? A duck?
A duck just standing there and talking to you?
Easy, right? Duck left Farmer Brown in charge and hit the campaign trail. He visited small diners. He marched in parades. He went to town meetings. He gave speeches that only other ducks could understand. On election day, what's election day? Jesley?
For voting.
On election day, the voters filled out their ballots in the booths all over the state. The vote was counted and the results were posted in the local paper. Miss Governor, 999,999. Duck, 300,000. Who won?
Duck,
right? He had one more vote than Miss Governor.
Who won?
We're going to go over the results. The governor demanded a recount. Two sticky ballots were found stuck to the bottom of a plate of pancakes. The new tally was, Mrs. Governor, 999,999. Duck, 300,002. The voters had spoken. Duck was officially in charge. How do we know Duck was in charge? Aria?
He had more votes.
Running a state is very hard work. At the end of each day, Duck was covered from head to toe in hairspray, ink stains, scotch tape, fingerprints, mayonnaise, and coffee stains.
Mayonnaise?
And he had a very bad headache. Running a state is no fun at all, thought Duck. That night, Duck and his staff started working on posters for the presidential election. What is Duck running for now?
A president.
Mark?
For president.
For the
White House.
Duck left his staff in charge and hit the campaign trail. He kissed babies in local diners. He rode in parades. He gave speeches that only other ducks could understand. He even played the saxophone on late night television.
Some big lips.
On election day, what's election day? Eli, what's election day?
A day where they vote for the president, government, or anything else.
Very good. On election day, the voters filled out their ballots in the booths all over the country. The vote was counted and the results were announced on CNN. Mr. President, 50,546,165. Duck, 50,546,170. The president demanded a recount. 10 sticky ballots were found stuck to the bottom of the vice president. The new tally was, Mr. President, 50,546,165. Duck, 50,546,180. The voters had spoken. Duck was officially in charge.
What?
How do we know that Duck won? Radislaw?
Because he got the most votes.
Because he got the most votes.
Oh my God.
So what is Duck now?
The president.
He's the president.
Yeah.
He's the government. He's the in charge for the.
He's the head of it. He's right?
Everything like that.
He can voting for that.
Ready? Running a country is very hard work. At the end of each day, Duck was covered from head to toe in face powder, paper cuts, staples, security badges, Secret Service agents, and coffee stains. And he had a very bad headache. Running a country is no fun at all, thought Duck. This is a picture of the Oval Office. That's where Duck is, and that's where the President of the United States office is. So, he's tired. He's head of the United States now.
He got stable.
Then he checked the help wanted ads. Duck needed, no experience necessary. Must be able to mow the lawn and grind coffee beans. Okay. So now, as good readers, let's think of everything we've learned from this book. We know the duck wasn't happy about the farm, so he went to run the farm. He wasn't happy. He wanted to move on to running the state, and now he's president. Now he sees a help wanted ad back on the farm that he used to work. I want you to turn and talk to your partners. I want you to predict what's going to happen next. Think about, do you think the duck's going to go back to the farm? Is he going to take his old job back? Jesley, what do you think is going to happen?
I think that he might take his job back.
Okay, he might take his job back, Radislav?
I think that he's gonna give his job, the president, to Farmer Brown.
Okay. Jason, what do you think's gonna happen?
He's gonna go wild.
Maybe. What? Aria, what do you think's gonna happen?
I think he's gonna go and
are we all listening to what Aria says?
He is gonna be president again.
Okay. Let's see. Remember, it's okay if our predictions aren't always correct. Duck left the vice president in charge and headed back to the farm. At the end of each day, ready? At the end of each day, Farmer Brown is now covered from head to toe in hay, horsehair, seeds, sprouts, feathers, filth, mud, muck, and coffee stains. And Duck. So Farmer Brown's the one who's covered, and Duck is working on his autobiography.
What's that? You don't know what is that?
Does anybody know what an autobiography is? Eli, what's an autobiography?
It's a story that is true. That's true.
An autobiography is a story that's true, and it's written about yourself. So he's writing a story about himself, and the first title of his story is Running a Farm is Very Hard Work. Does anybody remember what book starts with that? Running a Farm is Very Hard Work, Emma?
It was in the beginning?
It was in the beginning of this book. So this is Duck's autobiography. Okay? All right, so now you're going to go back to the seats. But first, I'm going to give you instructions. So you're going to fill this out. Our first question is, why do we have elections? Okay? And then the second thing you're going to do on your paper is draw a picture of a time you voted. So it could be on anything. What were some things that we said we voted on before?